हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू टॉपिक अबाउट द कार्बोहाइड्रेट मेटाबॉलिज्म, दैट इज ग्लाइकोजिनेसिस। व्हाट इज दिस ग्लाइकोजिनेसिस? इट इज सिंथेसिस ऑफ ग्लाइकोजन। सो हियर वी विल सी हाउ ग्लाइकोजन इज सिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम ग्लूकोज। सो व्हेन वी आर नॉट इन यूज ऑफ एनर्जी, दिस ग्लूकोज इट गोज एंड स्टोर्स इन फॉर्म ऑफ ग्लाइकोजन इन लीवर। सो हाउ दिस पाथवे टेक्स प्लेस? दिस पाथवे टेक्स प्लेस इन लीवर and how it is taking, that we will see here. So in glycogen metabolism two topics are covered. One is glycogenesis and one is glycogenolysis. So here in this lecture we will deal about glycogenesis. Now before that we just see the general chemistry. You can also see my one video is there about the general carbohydrate chemistry. There you can see what is glycogen and how it is functioning. So glycogen is a highly branched structure. You can see that it is highly branched structure. This is glycogenin, a protein, and these are the branches of glucose which forms highly branched glycogen. This highly branched polymer of glucose, it is, and it has 1,4 glycosidic bond in straight chain and 1,6 glycosidic bond at branch point. It is the storage form of glucose which is stored in the animal body, specially in liver and muscle. It is present only in animals, not in plants, in animals, and that too mainly liver and muscles. Glucose is rapidly delivered to the bloodstream when needed. Upon degradation of glycogen, the phenomena is known as glycogenolysis. When in the body, when in the cells, if glyco energy is needed, then this glycogen breaks down into glucose, and that process is known as glycogenolysis. And here we deal about the phenomena, that is glycogenesis, that is the synthesis of glycogen. So enough glucose, when there is enough glucose, then the energy triggers synthesis of glycogen, and that is known as what? Glycogenolysis. So today we will go with glycogenolysis. Now before that we see how the bonding is there in glycogen molecule. So glycogen is mainly made up of amylopectin molecule, which is highly branched. This glycogen has 1,4 bonding in the straight chain, whereas at the branch point, only at the branch point it is 1,6 bonding. Rest again then in the straight chain is 1,4 bonding. Only at the branch point it is 1,6 bonding, and straight chain it is 1,4. Now why glycogen is stored, not as glucose? Because glycogen, it serves as a buffer to maintain blood glucose level. So it maintains, acts as a buffer to maintain blood glucose level. So glucose is virtually the only fuel used by the brain except during prolonged starvation. The glucose from glycogen is readily mobilized and therefore a good source of energy for sudden and strenuous activity. Unlike fatty acid, the released glucose can provide energy in the absence of oxygen and can supply energy for anaerobic activity. So in the glycolysis we have seen that in the presence of oxygen and in the absence of oxygen, the glucose can only provide energy. Now biomedical importance of this glycogenesis. So liver glycogen, what is its importance? So liver glycogen is largely concerned with storage and supply of glucose 1-phosphate, which is converted to glucose for maintaining blood glucose. This glucose 1-phosphate is converted to glucose only in liver, because glucose 1-phosphatase enzyme is present only in liver. In muscle glycogen, it only acts as a provision for energy, but it cannot directly contribute to the blood glucose level because it does not have enzyme which converts this glucose 1-phosphate into glucose. That enzyme is glucose 1-phosphatase. So liver has that enzyme, but muscle does not have. That's why it directly does not contribute to blood glucose level. Then inherited deficiency of enzyme in the pathway of glycogen metabolism. So some of the enzyme deficiency produces certain inherited disorders that are known as inborn errors. These diseases are together known as glycogen storage disease. Now, metabolism of glycogen can be discussed under two headings. So, one is synthetic phase, that is known as glycogenesis. One is catabolic phase, that is known as glycogenolysis. Now, both pathways are different from each other. They are not just reversible. So, the synthesis of glycogen is not just the reverse of breakdown of glycogen. So, glycogen in any tissue is not static. It is different. Both processes are controlled at substrate level by end products and hormone. So both glycogenesis and glycogenolysis, both are controlled or inhibited or activated by end products and hormones. When glycogenesis occurs, glycogenolysis does not occur, and vice versa. So these two processes does not occur at a time. Together they don't occur. So when there is glycogenesis, glycogenolysis will not happen. When there is glycogenolysis, then glycogenesis will not appear. So these are two pathways because they are just reverse. So synthesis of glycogen, when there is synthesis of glycogen, breakdown of glycogen will not occur. Now, glycogenesis is what? It is the formation of glycogen from glucose. And the site we know, it is liver and skeletal muscles. But to some extent, it is in every tissue. Then, liver stores 4 to 6% of glycogen as per weight of organ. 12 to 18 hours of fasting totally deplete. Now, synthesis of glycogen, first step in glycogenesis, first step. It is not actually the first step, but it is just conversion of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. That we have seen in glycolysis, that glucose is phosphorylated in presence of enzyme glucokinase. Because this process takes place only in liver, that's why the enzyme presence is glucokinase and also hexokinase. In other tissue, the enzyme is only hexokinase. In liver, both are there, and in presence of magnesium ion, this ATP is converted to ADP and it gives one, or it donates one phosphate to glucose molecule, and this glucose is then phosphorylated and converted into glucose 6-phosphate. This glucose is transported into liver cell by a specific glucose transporter wherein it is immediately phosphorylated. Most of the glucose in cell is in the form of glucose 6. Now, first one step, that glucose 6-phosphate is converted into glucose 1-phosphate. So, this glucose is isomerized. It changes its position from phosphate, changes its position from 6 to 1st phosphate. So, we have already discussed in glycolysis that when the position of an substrate takes place, substitute takes place, then the enzyme is what? It is mutase or epimerase. So here the enzyme is mutase or epimerase. So the glucose 6-phosphate is converted to glucose 1-phosphate by enzyme phosphogluconeomutase, and this reaction is reversible reaction. Now, second step, this glucose 1-phosphate now takes a high molecular, that is UTP, which is equivalent to ATP. This UTP, it releases 1-phosphate molecule, and the UDP combines with glucose to form UDP glucose. This UDP glucose is a transporter. It transports this glucose to the already existing glycogen primer. So, active nucleotide uridine diphosphate glucose is formed under the influence of enzyme. The enzyme here is UDP glucose phosphorylase. The enzyme is UDP glucose phosphorylase, and elimination of phosphate takes place. Now, phosphoryl transfer, it is UTP energy is equivalent to ATP. This energy is used to activate glucose, and 2 phosphates from UTP are lost as phosphates. This phosphates is broken down to 2 phosphates, and driving the reaction to the right. Now the third step, that is glycogen synthesis. This glycogen synthesis occurs in presence of glycogen synthase enzyme. This glycogen synthase enzyme, what it is doing, it this UDP glucose transfers this glucose to already existing glycogen, that is known as glycogen primer. By the action of enzyme glycogen synthase, carbon 1 of the activated glucose of UDP glucose forms a glycosidic bond with carbon 4 of terminal glucose residue of glycogen primer. This is glycogen primer. This glycogen primer also, glycogen primer is also made up of glycogenin and some glucose molecule. That glucose, so the fourth carbon of this glucose and first carbon of this glucose, they bind with 1,4 glycosidic bond and start the formation of glycosidic bond and glycogen molecule start formation. So in this way, a pre-existing glycogen molecule or glycogen primer must be present to initiate the reaction. Then the glucose is always added to non-reducing ends. So it is added to non-reducing end. The glycosidic bond formed is 1,4 glycosidic bond and the enzyme is glycogen synthase. This glycogen synthase enzyme is inhibited by glucagon. It is regulated by enzyme glucagon. Now, glycogenin metabolism. What is this glycogenin? So, glycogenin is a protein that serves as an acceptor of glucose residue, making glycogenin plus glucose complex. This glucose is added at amino acid number this 194, which is tyrosine. The amino acid number 194, that is a tyrosine. The catalyzing enzyme is protein tyrosine glucosyl transferase. So name of the enzyme is transferase enzyme, but that is protein tyrosine glucosyl transferase. This glucose attaches its reducing side, keeping non-reducing side free. Non-reducing side is always free and reducing side, the carbon number 4 of reducing side glucose attaches with the first carbon of the new glucose 1-phosphate. So glycogenin adds another glucose forming 1,4 linkage and resulting in glycogenin glucose-glucose complex. See, now the branching of glycogen takes place. So the addition of glucose now adds, we have seen, and now branching takes place. So branching will take at 1,6 bonding, when the chain has been lengthened to minimum 11 to 12 glucose residues, a second enzyme comes, that is known as branching enzyme, that is also known as amylo 1,4-1,6 transglucosidase. This transfers a part of 1,4 chain, minimum length of 6 glucose residue, to a neighboring chain to form a 1,6 linkage, and it forms a 1,6 linkage. So now we can summarize the complete process. So first, glucose 6-phosphate is converted to glucose 1-phosphate in presence of enzyme glucokinase or hexokinase. Then glucose 1-phosphate is converted to UDP glucose by phosphoglucomutase and mutase enzyme. This UDP glucose, it releases UDP. Sorry, it releases phosphate, and this UDP is combined with this tyrosine molecule. This UDP glucose, it combines with glycogenin, or you can say glycogen primer. This is glycogenin and this is OH of tyrosine, then 194 amino acid. This here, this H and OH of this glucose combined to form water, and bonding is known as glycoside. So this UDP glucose, it combines with this and forms UDP glucose glycogen synthase. So glycogen synthase enzyme converts this into UDP glucose. It transfers, UDP is released and it forms this molecule glycogen primer. It contains 2 glucose. In this way, this UDP glucose are added. So let's see that this much till 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. 15 UDP glucose are added. So all they release glucose and they are again converted into UDP and forms again they are recycled. It forms this UTP, then it forms a in present glycogen synthase, it is converted into glycogen. This is straight chain glycogen. Now this straight chain glycogen is in the presence of branching enzyme is converted into alpha 1,6 bonding takes place and is converted into highly branched glycogen molecule. For the elongation of 1,4 takes and branching of 1,6 comes by branching enzyme, and in this way the molecule is glycogen molecules is synthesized from glucose. Now the clinical specs, the relation of glycogenesis with potassium influx into cells. Its clinical importance is in treatment of hyperkalemia when insulin and glucose are administered. So in hyperkalemia treatment, when insulin and glucose are administered or given to the patient, then the potassium level increases. So for that potassium level, treatment of that potassium level, this glycogenesis is very important. Importance in treatment of diabetic ketoacidosis with insulin and glucose. Danger the hypokalemia to precipitate. So the patient should be monitored for potassium level in blood while treating diabetes ketoacidosis with insulin and glucose effusion. Now the glycogenesis stimulation and inhibition. So glycogenesis is inhibited by protein phosphatase 1, and it is stimulated by insulin, by glucocorticoid which enhances gluconeogenesis and glycogen synthesis in liver. It increases activity of protein phosphatase 1, increase synthesis of enzyme glycogen synthase, and glucose also stimulate glycogenesis. High substrate concentration increases glycogenesis. Then hormonal regulation, we can see that glycogen synthesis is stimulated by insulin, and glycogenolysis, that is breakdown of glycogen, is stimulated by epinephrine and glucagon. Now regulation, we see epinephrine and glucagon when comes to the membrane, these hormones, then adenyl cyclase enzyme is activated. This adenyl cyclase enzyme, it converts ATP into cyclic AMP. This cyclic AMP, it converts inactive protein kinase to active protein kinase. This active protein kinase then activates glycogen synthase and converts synthesis of glycogen. Clear? But this active protein kinase, it converts phosphorylase kinase inactive to phosphorylase kinase active. It converts inactive phosphorylase kinase into active. And this active phosphorylase kinase, it converts inactive glycogen phosphorylase B into glycogen phosphorylase A is active, and this active, it converts glycogen into glycogen 1 phosphate. So here the glycogen breakdown is favored. So glycogen breakdown is favored and glycogen synthesis is inhibited. Okay, so this is the regulation of glycogen synthesis. So epinephrine and glucagon, they inhibit glycogen synthesis. How they inhibit glycogen synthesis? दिस एपिनेफ्रिन एंड ग्लूकागॉन दे एक्टिवेट एडिनाइल साइक्लेज एंजाइम. दिस एडिनाइल साइक्लेज एंजाइम इट कन्वर्ट्स एटीपी इनटू साइक्लिक एएमपी. दिस साइक्लिक एएमपी कन्वर्ट्स इनएक्टिव प्रोटीन काइनेज टू एक्टिव प्रोटीन काइनेज. दिस एक्टिव प्रोटीन काइनेज कन्वर्ट्स इनएक्टिव फॉस्फोराइलेज काइनेज इनटू एक्टिव फॉस्फोराइलेज काइनेज. दिस फॉस्फोराइलेज काइनेज इट एक्टिवेट्स वॉट इट एक्टिवेट्स इनएक्टिव फॉस्फोरिलेज इनटू एक्टिव ग्लाइकोजन फॉस्फोरिलेज. दिस ग्लाइकोजन फॉस्फोरिलेज इज एक्टिव. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंजाइम फॉर डिसोसिएशन ऑफ ग्लाइकोजन. सो वेन वी विल सी ग्लाइकोजिनोलाइसिस देयर वी विल सी दैट ग्लाइकोजिनोलाइसिस इज एक्टिवेटेड या ग्लाइकोजन इज ब्रेकन डाउन बाय एंजाइम ग्लाइकोजन फॉस्फोरिलेज. देन ग्लाइकोजन सिंथेसिस इज इनहिबिटेड इन दिस वे. बाय दिस ग्लाइकोजन सिंथेसिस इज इनहिबिटेड. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच. सो अवर इट्स फिनिश्ड. सो वी हैव डन. यू कैन ऑल्सो वॉच ग्लाइकोजिनोलाइसिस अवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो.